Well, a very good evening from the London Irish Centre here in Camden Square. It's been 2.5 months of blood, sweat and tears for tonight's competitors. For many, the first time they have ever set foot in a competitive boxing ring. A hugely admirable venture from some of the city's ordinary folk. Tonight is their opportunity to do something that is anything but ordinary. A 600-strong crowd packs the main ballroom at this fantastic venue in the heart of the city. Friends, family and colleagues alike sit amongst the crowd. The glitz and glam of London's nightlife combined effortlessly with the grittiest and toughest of sporting disciplines. 13 fights scheduled on tonight's bill, so buckle in for a big night of boxing here in London. This is Redemption.
Stepping into the right corner, make some noise for Mo
Well, Mo Taguri, born in 1985, so by my maths that makes him 28 years of age. Born in West London to Libyan parents. Come to London on their honeymoon, but they stay to raise 4 children, of which Mo is the youngest. So when Mo is not boxing, he enjoys many athletic pursuits. Plays rugby for Kilburn Cosmos. He goes running with his dog Humphrey. Said the first thing he's going to do after the fight tonight is have a Corona and 2 large Domino's pizzas. He said he's currently the world record holder for the biggest legs in the country. And his opponent, Jamie Myring, a market researcher, 23 years of age. And his favourite fighter, Mike Tyson. You may have heard of him. Said he had one fight in the WCB back in November. He lost that. Said, and since then, he's learned how to listen. He's learned how to defend. He's a much, much more rounded fighter. Far more confident. Really, really happy to be here. He's an orthodox fighter. Likes to stay on the back foot. In his corner, Alex Jackson. The two of them have become very good friends throughout the process. So they've really bonded. Built up a real good working relationship, built on trust and mutual respect. And that is what white collar boxing is all about. Alex Jackson just giving his final instructions to James Myring. Big lads squaring off in the centre of the ring, Mo Taguri and James Myring. Looking at them, I'd say we could be in for a bit of a tear up here. Now the bell for the first round goes, scheduled for 3. Both men circling to the left, Mo Taguri coming forward with a jab. James Myring staying out of the way of that good head movement from Myring. Taguri muscling him into the ring. And our cameraman ringside's done well to stay on the canvas there. Don't know how he did. I think a bit of rope usage. The referee will want to minimise that kind of behaviour, that's for sure. Taguri comes forward with a 1-2, clubbing left and right, and he's caught Myring on the back foot there, trying to muscle him into the corner. Left hook, Myring goes down. The referee sends him to the neutral corner. Legs have gone a little bit stiff there from Myring. Big left hook it was. And Mo Taguri, through that left hook, caught his man off balance. And he has scored a knockdown. Will count against Myring when the points are totted up if it goes the full 3 rounds. Solid jab from Mo Taguri. Myring just looking a little bit bamboozled at the beginning of this first round. We've got half a boxing match, half a wrestling match here. Mo Taguri seems to have a very big following here. He comes forward again, left, and then an overhand right. Only glanced ahead of Meiring. He's taken a couple of other shots, and he's keen to try and tie his man up in the corner. Slugfest of an opening round. Bit of blood to the nose of Motegheri as he goes back to his corner. So one round down out of three between Motegheri and James Meiring. Remember that knockdown came after about 30 odd seconds of James Meiring. Will count against him. That will have been a 10-8 round if the judges saw the rest of it in Tagiri's favour. He comes forward with a jab again to Tagiri and leaves with the right hand. Meiring's well off balance here. The two muscling each other right onto the ropes. It's a real muscle flying around in that ring. We've got to try and clean this one up a little bit. Blood from the nose of Motegheri. Whether that will impede his breathing or not, all yet to be seen. He comes forward, circling to his left. Comes in for the jab. Meiring counters it with the left. And then Tagiri faints. Left hook, he's caught Meiring. Meiring on wobbly legs. He's gone down again. Perhaps a slip that time. Certainly off balance and caught with a couple of heavy shots before he went down. Looked like he was on his way. The referee is coming over, saying, look, you can't throw your man to the floor, but does play a little bit of rugby. So that's what he's used to. And Tagiri comes forward again, Meiring circling to his left now. Big telegraph punch for him. Tagiri there, really swinging away. Not the most technical of affair, they don't mind me saying so. Well, Meiring asking for his head guard just to be tightened downwards a little bit there. Tagiri coming forward with a jab again. Meiring just slowing slightly. Two swinging away. Tagiri landing a couple of big left hooks. Blood pouring from the nose of Tagiri at the moment. He must have taken a fair old whack to that. Yeah, halfway through the second round and a couple of tired bodies in there. So third and final round, Motegheri and James Meiring in the blue. Motegheri coming forward, jab to the body. Looking for that looping overhand right. Both exchange a jab again. Aggressive encounter. Myring trying to pounce on his man as he was off balance. It's getting a little bit untidy now. Almost resembling more of a street fight than a boxing match at the moment. Big heavy blows. Nice left hook landed from Myring there. Taguri comes forward, slapping left hand. I don't know whether how much of that landed with the knuckle part of the glove or the inside. A couple of worried faces in the crowd to my left. Myron comes forward with a jab again. And both men really struggling to find their range. Just reaching a little bit with the punches and telegraphing those right hands and left hooks. Taguri with a nice 1-2. Myron with his back to the ropes. Backhand there thrown by Taguri. The referee seems to have let it go. I'm not sure whether he saw it or not. Nice jab from Taguri there. Stiff jab lands. Two of them touch gloves. Big hug in the middle of the ring. And the crowd applaud. So loud in here. Can hardly hear myself speak.
And you're going to try and appreciation for both
your fighters. Big cheers from the crowd. I think that knockdown in the first round could be all that really separates these two men. Not the tidiest of affairs by any stretch. Perhaps the power shots from Mo Taguri in the first minute or so just became the difference. We'll find out in a couple of moments anyway. The knockdown was the difference in the end for Mo Taguri. Big shot it was. Put James Myring down. Unfortunately, it just wasn't something he was able to come back from in the end. Good scrap between these two. Mo Taguri has earned that beer and the two pizzas. Go and enjoy them, mate.